I'm sure you'll find someone to go with you.
No, I won't. I'm so fat and gross.
Oh.
I should just kill myself.
Oh, that's... Come on.
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna kill myself because no one will go with me.
Oh. All right, Meg, look. What if I drove you and walked in with you or whatever?
Brian, will you go with me?
Are you gonna kill yourself if I don't?
Yeah.
Well, then my hands are pretty much tied.
Oh, Brian, thank you. Oh,
I have to buy a new dress. All the ones I have make me look fat.
Oh.
Brian, that was amazing. No one's ever stood up for me like that.
Hey, no problem. She's a skank. You don't deserve all the crap you get, Meg. You know that?
Thanks, Brian.
Sorry, that was the booze, not you. You gonna eat that?
Well, she seems to have taken a shine. Little encouragement. You might get her to put her cankles behind her ears.
Stewie, shut up. Who the hell is texting me at 8 a.m.?
Wait a minute. Something did happen last night.
Look, it's not that big a deal, all right? We just made out a little.
Ah! Tell me about it. Go.
It didn't mean anything. I had a few too many, and it's not even worth going into.
Hi, honey.
What?
I was thinking about our kiss last night. I never knew how flat and wide your tongue was.
Yeah.
You know, I've thought about how you stood up for me at the dance and all the nice things you said. We should totally be boyfriend and girlfriend.
Well, Meg, you know what's strange? I think I might be gay. I saw this penis on the internet today, and I thought to myself, well, that's just fine.
I'm going to the mall later. Maybe you can come and help me pick out some underwear?
I don't think that's going to be a possibility. I have plans.
Oh, there's the cute prom couple.
Hi, Mom. Is it cool if Brian and I go to the mall this afternoon?
Actually, I thought I was pretty clear.
Oh, of course it's okay. Ever since that dance, you two have become such good friends. Who would have thought?
Oh, we're more than friends, Mom. Last night at the dance, Brian...
Well, last night we decided to be best friends. Right, Meg? Come on, let's go to the mall. Well, we'll get you a big old pretzel.
I want a pretzel, too!
Look, this has gone a little too far. I like you. I think you're great. But what happened at the dance was... I mean, that kiss was just a mistake.
Oh, no. Did I do something wrong? Was it because I didn't sniff your butt first?
What? No. I mean, yes, that's how I would know you were interested. But, Meg, the fact is, you and I are friends, and that's the way it needs to stay. Besides, I have a girlfriend. I'm dating Jillian.
All right, Brian. I understand.
Good. I'm gonna grab Stewie, and then we can go.
A few moments later.
What's that, Brian? Oh, you were just kidding. Oh, I know you were. I love you too, Brian. And you love me. You do love me, Brian. Brian?
Oh, Meg, hey. Hey, listen, I hope you're feeling all right about our little talk the other day. You know, about us being just friends and all.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm fine. I'm fine. And... Hey, look, I want to thank you for being so great to me. So, I baked you a pie.
Oh, wow. Hey, that looks delicious. Oh, this is good. What's in there?
Well, there's some apples and some cinnamon and my hair.
What?
My hair is in the pie, Brian. And now it's inside of you. Part of me is inside of you, Brian. Do you feel me, Brian? Do you feel me inside of you?
Ooh, you got some pie, huh? Can I have a piece?
Sure.
Ooh, let me have some of that Cool Whip.
You're eating hair! Lois, can I talk to you for a second? I think we may have a problem with Meg.
You're telling me she's been locked in a room all day. Who knows what she's doing up there?
So here's the thing, and don't get mad, and that part I can't stress enough. That's a great shirt, by the way. I may have made out with Meg. Okay, I had that coming.
What the hell is wrong with you, you sick bastard? arrested?
Look, I was drinking.
Oh, what a shock.
Look, the short version is, this morning she made me eat the hair in her pie. No, it's not what you think. Stewie had some too. Stop punching me!
Look, Brian, I don't know what the hell happened between you two, but you better go upstairs and straighten it out right now. Peter, I haven't seen Meg or Brian since last night. I think something may have happened.
Mom, is it bad if I saw Meg tie up Brian last night, put him in the trunk of his car, and then drive away?
What? Chris, why didn't you say anything?
I dropped the ball. I'm sorry. I have just been buried in paperwork for the past 72 hours.
Oh, my God. Brian was right. Meg really must be obsessed with him. Oh, Peter, we gotta find them.
Don't worry, Lois. We're the police, and we'll do our very best to find Brian and girl Chris.
I'm really having a great time tonight, Brian. I can't believe you went to all this trouble.
Well, you know me.
Oh, I do, Brian. I know you so well. So, are you ready?
For what?
For the fun we're gonna have, Brian. We're gonna have fun tonight. Good, old-fashioned, all-American fun!
Listen, Meg, I'm not gonna lie to you here. I'm a little uncomfortable.
Oh, just relax. We're gonna be here for a while.
Well, I don't know if... Wait, what?
Good. Good for Brian.
Don't move, dirtbag!
Holy crap, what the hell is this?
Brian, she's a teenager!
Meg, you need to let Brian go!
But Mom, I love him!
Honey, you're just confused.
I'm not confused! I've never been more certain about anything in my life! I need him!
Meg, I know that's what you think right now, but you're not... Oh, God, I wish I could make you understand. You don't know what you need.
I know what she needs.
You do?
You bet. Bring her by my house around 8:30 tonight. I'll take care of her.
Hi, Mr. Quagmire. Mom said I should come over here.
Have a seat, Meg. Soon it'll all become clear. Excuse me while I get a little more comfortable. Now, you probably just think of me as square old Mr. Quagmire from next door, but I've been around the block a few times, learned a couple things, and I can tell you this. There's no reason to grow up too fast, but you've got all the time in the world and a lot of wonderful experiences ahead of you. Hang on, I want to give you something. This book helped me when I was about your age. It let me know that as long as I kept on rolling, I'd find that one person who would make me whole.
Thanks, Mr. Quagmire.
Oh, you don't have to thank me. Now get on out of here, you little scamp.